Panasonic's high-end HD camcorders have been favourites here at Trusted Reviews for a couple of years now, but its lower-end models have had a more muted reception. They've recently been updated to the 60 series, such as the HDC SD60 I have here. Let's see if it gives Panasonic total HD camcorder domination at last. The HDC SD60 arrives alongside the HS60 and TM60. Where the latter two sport a built-in hard drive and flash memory respectively, the SD60 relies on removable SD cards instead. The three models are otherwise basically identical. A quick glance at the specifications already brings some good news. Whereas Panasonic's previous generation of lower-end HD camcorders incorporated a tiny 6th-inch CMOS, the SD60 and its siblings use a larger 1/4.1-inch sensor, which promises better performance in low light, a key deficiency with the previous generation. The sensor has a gross 3.3 megapixels, which allows 5 megapixel stills with a bit of interpolation. Despite the larger sensor, the SD60 manages to offer a not inconsiderable 25 times optical zoom. Panasonic has also mirrored its recent higher-end models and put the extra pixels available on the CMOS to use to provide an intelligent zoom. This further stretches the telephoto to 35 times, but without the drop in resolution normally associated with traditional digital zooms. Unlike Panasonic's latest top models, the SD60 doesn't offer 50 progressive frames per second shooting as its top quality mode. Instead, this remains the full HD at 17 megabits a second with 25 interlaced frames a second offered by Panasonic HD camcorders for some years now. The SD60 is not exactly replete with discrete control buttons either. The only ones worth mentioning toggle manual mode and switch between the two image stabilization options. These are optical and include the Power OIS with advanced mode introduced alongside the TM10 and TM350 in 2009. In our testing, the extra mode is well worth having as it smooths out jerkiness more effectively when shooting whilst walking or handheld at full telephoto. Everything else is operated via the touchscreen. This includes the AFAE mode where you can simply touch a point within the frame to set focus and exposure. This will also track faces and use these as reference. The face detection system now has a smile shutter option in still image mode. You can also set focus manually using a rather fiddly on-screen slider. There's a slider for separate aperture and shutter controls. These can be configured independently, and video gain is available when the iris is fully open. Aside from the digital cinema and soft skin options, there are also color and image controls available, buried deep within the menu system. You can adjust sharpness, color, and white balance temperature. Alternatively, there's the usual array of scene modes. Overall, the manual settings are extensive, although total reliance on the touchscreen makes these less accessible than with Panasonic's lens ring-equipped high-end models. At least important functions like AFAE, pre-rec, macro mode and backlight compensation are just a few screen presses away. Naturally, being a budget model, the SD60 doesn't have enthusiast features like an accessory shoe or mini jacks for headphones or an external microphone, but these are far from essential at this price and you still get manual audio level control. Panasonic's much improved wind noise canceller is also available. In bright sunlight, the SD60 produces rich colour and plenty of detail. Panasonic's intelligent control system manages to prevent the brightest areas from blowing out, or detail being completely lost in areas of shadow. The promise of the larger CMOS is also borne out in low light. Where Panasonic's previous generation at this price level struggled to maintain colour and avoid grain as illumination decreased, the SD60 keeps the image brighter and freer of noise to lower lighting levels. In our key living room lit by a single 100-watt light bulb test, the SD60 achieved a very serviceable picture, showing it will cope well with indoor social gatherings under relatively poor artificial lighting. Available for less than £350, the Panasonic HDC SD60 is a tempting proposition. Previous entry-level HD models were let down by their low light performance, but with the obvious improvements in this area, the SD60 provides very competitive image quality for a keen price. It's a great value choice for general home and holiday shooting.